Football. Bet with 1xBet.
Welcome to another edition of the Sportswoman. This show happens every Thursday, 2:30 p.m. to 3:30 p.m. Disciplinary committee docked 6 points and 6 goals and a fine of 5 million shillings to Proline FC for failure to honor a fixture. And of course, it says that Proline is still using an old rule of 2001 on international debts, but it doesn't quote the new rule. Today, we have the CEO of Proline, that is William Bakabulindi. He'll be explaining to us what the club is going to do next. And of course, we'll discuss about the Ugandan team, that is the COSAFA under 17, that is already in camp ahead of the Mauritius tourney. And of course, we won't forget to talk about the UPL fixture and the games that have been slated over the weekend and many more others. Welcome on the show. My name is Becky Cynthia Nachimera. You can find me on Twitter at Becky Cynthia N and on Facebook, Becky Cynthia Nachimera. Welcome, Faith.
Thank you, Becky.
That's cold.
It's so stilted the way you asked. The way you asked me, I had to go with what was instinctive. Mm. Welcome.
Thank you. Welcome back, Superwoman, Super Lady, Adon Sharon. How's Naivasha?
Naivasha was so cold, but very, very cold, extremely cold. Mm. Just imagine you're in East Africa and you're covering yourself. You're in East Africa, but you're covering yourself with 3 blankets, you know? Like, what is this? living with flamingos and at the Rift Valley. Was when we studied geography, I had admired so much to go to the Rift Valley region, but this time round, I stayed there for 1 week and I'm like, what? I need to go back to Uganda. I didn't know the weather was just
no investor
horrible.
Near you?
No, what?
Are you hard?
No.
Okay,
you know
fine.
What? School. So all right. But I love Faith's hair. I'm happy to be back and getting Faith in a new hairstyle. I don't know whether that
sponsored
is real hair
by the
or
Turkish.
It is Chiwani.
I bought it.
You bought it?
Okay. That's all you should know.
It is okay.
I mean,
if they give you the money, the investor gives you the
check.
Money, of course.
My dear, I'm paid very well by New Vision.
Anyway, before we begin the show officially, Faith, can you take us through the highlights of your week?
The week for me, I would say, has been a little up and down. I would say over the weekend, of course, I was in Kumba covering the Kumba Open Volleyball. And if you're looking at going into something interesting, me, I think I'll be traveling to Lira for the national championship.
Yeah, France.
Okay. So that requires me in Uganda.
Danny is in Lira watching. He must be so happy. When are you going?
I hope to travel at worst Saturday, but I hope for tomorrow.
So you would chamo gweno kunumo.
Hey, I'm coming. And Dong?
Yeah, my highlight of the week is a 19-year-old Bianca showing her role model, the Canadian, showing her role model. Of course, the lady who Fiona Pinky,
Serena Williams.
You know, one thing that I liked most is that she says she's been preparing for this lady for close to 1 year, emotionally, physically, and mentally. So, and you know, she said it wasn't easy to play against an experience and one of the best female tennis players we have in the globe. So me, that was my highlight. And someone's like, why wouldn't you support Serena Williams? But I'm like, no, it's time for us, for the young people. Yeah, to also show something out.
We shall support other people when Serena wins number 24.
Of course, anyway. She could not win it because of, the lady cut Serena's dream shot.
Losing? That's 4 times?
Yes. Ever since she gave birth.
In final, she has lost.
Yeah, ever since she came back in 2018 after giving birth. That's
but
a four.
It also says a lot about how terrible, the women, how weak women's tennis is. Because Serena can't make 4 finals in a row. Mm-hmm. Of course, she has lost in those 4 finals, but this is someone who's supposed
to be...
Still
meant she was a giant.
Yeah, it means this is someone who's supposed to be, in her final legs, let's say, or her good evening of her career.
She's actually supposed to be in a good night, not even good evening.
Okay, anyway, let's welcome William Baka. He's from Proline FC. Welcome on the show. This is Sportswoman.
Thank you. I'm glad to be here.
We're glad to have you.
We don't buy it.
Just relax.
We don't buy it.
Well, yeah. The evidence of what I've seen, I might not be so sure.
At about 10:50 a.m., we saw a document circulating about how Proline was fined and lots of more things. What do you have to say about that document?
First and foremost, we expected it. Actually, the running joke in office as we were submitting our submission to the disciplinary committee is that we should take both our submission and the appeal at the same time, because we kind of suspected this. We've been operating in this space for quite some time.
Okay. Yeah. So you know the politics there?
Yeah, we know. We expected this was going to be the outcome. So. They can be sure the appeal is also ready, and we are going to submit it as well.
So if you knew the politics around, why did you continue acting on that?
You see, when you feel in your bones that you're right, nothing should stand in your way. If you're right, you're right.
Were you right or the law was right?
You're right because the law says what you're saying, what you're doing. Mm. You see what I mean? So when... Sorry?
It's okay.
When you're backed by the law, it doesn't matter if you're standing alone or with several other people, you know you're right, so nothing phases you.
First of all, my question is, why did you people fail to honor the fixture? Why?
First and foremost, we would have played this fixture. Let me put this out there. We would have played this fixture if we were at full strength. Yeah? Modern football right now, you can't take, you can't knowingly go into a fixture when you are weakened. Every point counts this season, if you, anywhere in football. I always use the example that people know very well in Premier League. Take Messi, European football. European. Take Messi out of Barcelona. Will it be the same side? Well, the same side? But how many players did they register? So. That thing of only two players, you can't fail to play only two players, but these are kingpins. The national team cannot come for average players. They come for your best.
What does the law say? Two players, three players? Because according to what I have, it says if a club has three or more players in the national team, the fixtures involving such a club may be called off 3 days before and after the national team engagement. If it is to be played in Uganda, may be called off 3 days before departure and 3 days after return from engagement outside Uganda. Yeah. How?
So which law was he using? The old or the new law? Because the old law stated that two, but then that law was amended to three. So there, which law was
there using? Is even a law of the other season that said one, but all that does, notwithstanding, those laws do not operate in the international week. Because the International Week has already been talked about by FIFA. Okay. FIFA says during the International Week, there should be no national championship matches. That thereby makes, it renders all those other laws null and void in this period. But if you have your SECAFA, you have your COSAFA, you have whatever, then these laws can come in because they are outside FIFA dates. And outside FIFA dates, a club has the mandate to say, no, take one or take two. There you can negotiate. But in FIFA dates, you can't, even if they come for eight.
Okay. Yeah. I also have another, the release of players for national association representative matches. It says the player shall also be released for the period for preparation. If the player is called up to play in a qualifying match for an international competition, this period shall be 4 days. Within what period were your players summoned?
Like I said, I am not even going to look at how and when our players were summoned, because when you're in the International Week, these players literally belong to the national team. They can come for any player at any time. Even if they had reached Nairobi and called us that send us your goalkeeper, they were within the confines of what is right within their law that it's International Week, these players belong. And therefore, you don't have to litigate it in any way with these other local laws.
When When you, I saw a letter Proline wrote to the Federation requesting the Federation and UPL to allow them not play against Sports Club Villa, but the response was, because I even talked to the CEO of UPL, I later on called him, the response was that they have not honored the letter, Proline should go on and play the match. And indeed, I went to that social media forum, Facebook, they actually confirmed after that letter had come that yes, the match between Proline and SC Villa will be played. But again, when SC Villa reported there, there were no Proline players, no Proline officials. What happened? Could there be someone who was misusing your social media account? Or maybe there's someone who is thinking the other side and you guys are thinking the other side?
Yes, I agree that the post went up that the game is on, and it came down approximately 3 minutes later, because the person who was updating our social media was informed that, wait, the committee is still deciding on what to act with this response from the UPL. And when we decided after that meeting about an hour later that, look, the law is on our side, we are not going to play, we promptly put out the release, we wrote to the UPL, and we also corrected our social media status.
First of all, has UPL ever given you rules that you follow as a
No.
club? You don't have?
No, we don't have. The thing is, I was part of the committee at one point that came up with, that were governing the rules, yeah? And I know what happens when you have rules, when you're doing rules. You do the rules, you give them to stakeholders,
to
they go through and they say, okay, yes. You know, and there's general consensus. That's what rules are, that's what the laws are. But just after that, that went on, we got rules, competition rules, season 1920, you know? And you can ask any club. I don't think any club has been given those set of rules to comprehend or to look at or whatever, you know? So all this is murky. But what our insistence is this. Once it is international break, all these things do not matter. Mm. Yes.
Okay, maybe before Faith comes in, is there something not right in the camp of Proline or in the house of Proline? Here I am concerned because one, the first saga started with the issue of
right.
your public relations officer, the acting
officer.
Public relations officer or media officer. When he was dropped, he was not taken, and I saw so many outcries on social media, and yet this was a very
first
active.
Of all, you know his JD.
That's what I'm saying, acting, acting, acting. Yes?
Is he still acting?
I don't know whether he's still acting. Do we think there are structures in the club that handle such issues? Because now when you talk about the issues of the fixture that is under competitions, now again when you come to the secretariat, there is so much cry coming out. Do we see Proline being run by only two people, you the CEO and the director? Because the issue of the public relations officer or the media officer up to today has not been settled, and the public has not known who is running your day-to-day activities besides you, because the CEO cannot do everything. What is happening at Proline?
First and foremost, I would like to tell you that the camp in Proline is very okay. It's very okay, and everything is being operated at a good pace. I don't know if I should speak about Ronnie. Is that? But anyway, the thing is this: when there's an international match, there are so many things to consider. Yeah. And first and foremost, the basics have to be there. If somebody is to travel, they should have. Can you go anywhere without a passport?
You can't.
Why didn't you? Because according to our investigation, it states that his papers were submitted with the ones of players.
Mm.
But at the end of it all, you chose to fight for the players.
But you see, Sharon, I think it's one of the prerequisites a person has to have.
Yes,
even if I'm going for a trip, even if I'm representing the company,
yes.
The first question my boss would ask, where is your passport?
Exactly.
I would like
if
to
you
ask
don't
Sharon.
Have it, you
so
have to chase for it.
No.
And the opportunity might be given to another person who is ready.
My
that shows you're not ready.
Mm.
Is there a problem at Proline as an institution?
Mm.
Because this is our club.
Let
we
me,
are proud
yeah,
of it. Is there a problem with someone else?
There's no problem. I want you to recall that when we went to Sekafa, we took Ronnie. Yeah? and SEKAFA was only taking care of only 25 people, but we took 35 people. Because Rwanda, it's okay for somebody to go without a passport.
Yes, yes.
But
East
now,
Africa.
Yeah, East Africa. Africa. But now it's Malawi. Somebody doesn't have a passport. How do you take that person? And then let me go to the other issue that you raised. Yeah, much as we can help the staff to get a passport, it is not mandated on us that we should get them a passport. Mm. You see, you work for the New Vision. Did the New Vision get you a passport that you use?
I don't need to put it clearly.
You see, so now,
no, but
the thing is...
That's, you take care of that. Even the national teams, they'll tell you.
Mine was not about the passport. I think we're just going on the issue of the passport.
Let's wind that up, then we'll get back to...
It's okay. We now understand where the problem was. But...
And if you look at the original list, by the way, the original list that people were supposed to travel, Ronnie's name is there.
Now, because now you're talking about also issue of cost coming in, indirectly you're putting in the issue of cost. Mm. But the Federation itself also said, okay, now we are going to help clubs at who are representing us at the continent. Mm. So then if assume that the Federation was not there, how about the other finance that he had put aside? Mm. What could have helped or maybe in some other stuff?
Now you're trying to tell us how to
apportion
the finances.
Not telling you. I am seeking guidance from you, because you put it very clear here that we have to budget.
Yeah.
And probably, yes, which I agree with you. Mm. I've been into football management. I know how difficult it is. That one I cannot pin you on this. Mm. But what I'm saying that now that even the Federation had come in to help, so the issue of budget should have not been a problem.
But okay, let me just address that fact. We put several papers there at the passport office.
Immigration.
But you all know Proline does not run that office, you know. So when we have players who don't have passports, and we need to get several passports out, who do you think we are going to put emphasis on? A staff member or players? Of course, we went to get the players' passports out first. And by the way, some of those players got the passports on that day.
Yeah, it is possible because we know what happens that day.
Yeah, so it's unfortunate. I brought Ronnie in. I taught him so many things. And it's unfortunate that we got...
Ronnie who told us this. Like I told you, I got from social media. Because I'm like, why are people ranting?
I saw the social media rants, but... They were unjustified. So I didn't give them time to
process the passport. Yeah, someone offered that. So
I didn't give them time.
Now, William, I'm still not contented. As a CEO of a particular club, fine, whatever happens. Were you trying to show FUFA that you are big somehow? No, because, I mean, two players cannot affect me.
Right they now, cannot, Villa, before you even answer the question, Villa has gotten four players now, someone for the national team. Mm. And as I said right now, those players, the two for Chan, for Hippos, I've already reported the camp there in Nigeria. That's Ruanga and Gavin. Mm. And then you also have Saidi Kenny and the other one. Saidi Kenny, yes, and Owori David. So regardless, because the Saidi Kenny and Owori David, they will go after, I think, tomorrow's game. Now, should also Villa come out with a letter that we are not going to play Honda tomorrow's fixture against Express because of the two players? What do you think?
Honestly, for me, like I said, in Uganda, we over believe in ambiguous laws. Half the time, people can stretch the law as far as they can. And I think maybe in this incident, I think even Proline felt, you know what, we can also stretch the law as far as we can, because this is what it said, this is what FIFA says, this is what FIFA says. I think though, I think instead of sometimes handing out these bans and, you know, fines and what, sometimes FUFA, it's better to engage people. The way we had that women's conference, sometimes it's better you call teams and sit down and come up with ways. Because at the end of the day, you need these clubs to get the players fit and for you to be able to choose from an array of talented players. Yeah? You have to be able to, because sooner or later, soon clubs will be telling players you're injured. Before,
but you see, this has spaces. This message has spaces because police... Did they do anything to police? Was this done when they failed to honor the first
match? The issue of police, we are not sure whether they're even going to... We aren't sure yet whether they're going to summon them, but for the last time I managed to engage officials at UPL,
I said, okay, fine, now Proline has done this, and I think, because me was like, I think punishment is coming along Proline. Now how about the police's case? Because for police it was even worse. Police sent an email, and then they did not follow up even on that email. Now police decides to call the CEO of UPL after reaching where? After reaching Nairobi. That for them, they're not there for the match, and they're like, yee, what happened? So we are yet to wait. Because if police is not punished, then definitely we see it is injustice. There's no fairness, because we need to have fairness, yeah? Yeah.
And anyway, just to remind you that our lines are open for this discussion. You can reach us on 0414-33-78-72. The number is 0414-33-78-72. You can call in and be a part of the discussion. Yes.
Yeah, you were asking about the fact that it's only two players. And that is where I want us to go away from. And that's where I beseech the powers that be at FUFA. Okay. To this law is for lack of a better word, archaic. These days, in modern football, even one player is too big. It's too much. Yeah? I just gave you the example of Messi at Barcelona. Or take Van Dijk out of Liverpool. It will not be the same team. And if you are fighting for those points and you really need those points, it ceases to be a question of how many players. It now becomes a question of, have you taken my player? And what is the mitigation? The reason why FIFA came up with this law that in international break, no league matches, was to do away with exactly this. And when this happened, and this thing there, the DC is giving us, they are comfortably quoting a law that we upheld.
Okay.
You know that if the national team comes along, you have to give it your players. We did that. We didn't fight that at all. But we are saying, because of this same thing, FIFA protected us and said, you don't have to play. Other people can play if they allow. If you come to me and tell me, let me take your players, but will you play or not? Let me have the leeway of saying, okay, you take them, I'll play. Or I will not play. Will you stomach that? You know, something like that.
Yeah.
But it's not a one-way street.
So you're following FIFA
football.
Rules.
Yeah, this is modern football. Even in our neighboring Rwanda, journalists were asking me the same thing. How come you guys are playing on the international break? This is not rocket science. It is done everywhere. Is Uganda so special? Is Uganda so different from every other footballing nation that we have to play during the international break, and it is by force, and if you don't, they'll come high-handed.
So what's the way forward?
Are you paying the 5 million fine?
We are appealing. We are not accepting this decision. We are going to appeal.
Yes.
And let me tell you guys.
FIFA says.
FUFA
so I'm saying, are you going to FIFA appealing?
We are going to appeal. No, before you go to FIFA, you have to exhaust all.
All, yes.
And we are going to appeal to FUFA. If they refuse, we are going to the Court of Arbitration for Sports in Switzerland. This thing has to end somewhere.
So will it be more expensive paying the? Will it be cheaper paying the fine than going around?
Let us do things that are right.
So would you feel free to be relegated?
Well, someone who said,
"No,
spend the 5 million because Villa wants the money."
But the money is not given to Villa.
It was a joke.
Yeah, it was a joke. But sometimes jokes go on because Villa last season was fined on something very small. It was a game. I remember it was Villa, and Bright Stars. You know, the coach has the mandate, has the role to go and talk to the referee, more especially when the field officiation was not fine at halftime. And I was there by the Bamway, and I walked in smartly without even attacking William Oloya. But the report was written that Villa's coach attacked the referee, and we were paid, I think, around 2-3 million shillings. Can you imagine that?
So maybe he was quiet, but in their opinion, he was charging the referee.
Anyway, like I said, would you feel free? Because right now, this whole process is going to be kind of a very long process, going to FUFA, and then after that, tell you wait, and then go to the Court of Arbitration. By the time you're going there, already the league is going on, and already 6 points docked. Don't you think it's going to leave the club at the state of quagmire? And don't you see that already the state of you exiting the Premier League might be knocking?
You know, we've been relegated twice, right? So that is not a threat anymore. We can be relegated. That's okay. But the principle should be right. That's our thing. we shall go on and play the league matches as they set them. And they can dock the 6 points and the 6 goals and whatever. But at the end of the day, I am very sure that if we get where we have to go, if we get to a sane person, to a sane mind who can interpret these rules properly for us, they will bring back those points and goals. Because the rule, it cannot be any clearer, by the way.
What law did they... Okay, before we go on, let's pick the person online. Hello, caller.
Hello.
Hello, caller. Hello.
How are you? Hello.
How are you?
Fine, and you?
Fine.
Okay.
Hello. Sorry, we lost that caller.
Airtime,
yeah. Anyway, yeah, I was asking, in the document, is there any law that they quoted, you know, for... I mean, the decision they made for, you know, the fines and docking the points, what law did they use?
Of course, they still run to the local law, and they completely ignore what we are telling them about international break. They did not even address that. They told us something that we did. We allowed players to go to the national team, and that's what they are quoting. They are not saying anything about what the fate of national league is in the international break. They didn't address that. Yeah. If you tell me that I'm quoting an old law of 2001, tell me what the new one says, because I'll tell you this, it is not there. The law that we are working on,
maybe
is that
it's
one
on
of
the website.
We have checked the website everywhere.
But if the laws are on the website and I run them, I can even go on the website and delete a particular.
I asked William whether they were called to go and hear the side of the story.
No.
Were you summoned?
No, nothing. And we categorically put it in our submission that we would like to be, because we have the right to face our accuser.
Exactly.
But we were not given that chance. Mm-hmm. I think in their wisdom, they thought, hey, we already have our verdict. Why do we have to call them? Mm-hmm. But the truth of the matter is this. A law can be as old as nature. As long as it has not been amended, it is still what we go by. Mm-hmm. The Constitution of Uganda has some parts that have not been touched since it was put up. Does it mean that those parts have null and void? Of course not. Even FIFA itself has laws that have not been touched since they were made. Does it mean they are null and void? Of course not. This law was put there in 2001. And now you're telling me because it is 2001, it is an old law. Okay, you show me the one of 2019 that tells me I am wrong.
Faith, where is the new
one? How about the one that Becky read that was amended?
Which one?
The law that you read which was amended.
If
he's talking about the FUFA, unless he's talking about the FIFA laws.
This one, if a club has three or more players, this one.
This one has, this one has been amended like 10 times.
Like,
it has. At one point, it was only one player.
It was one player.
It was only one player. Now, suddenly, this season, it is three players.
It's
okay.
Just like
football
I told you.
Rules are being amended all the time because football is also evolving. It's okay. But you tell me that FIFA amended the international break rule from this to this. And then I'll say, okay. And by the way, at Proline, we are very humble. If we are wrong, you will see a press release from me admitting that we have been wrong.
Sure.
We are sorry for whatever we have put you people through, and we shall pay the fine, and we shall accept those things.
So for us, we should...
So Faith, do you think the decision FUFA made without summoning Proline was fair enough?
Like I said, FUFA conducts business with fines. I mean, there's never enough time for you to answer, I mean, for you to come up with a good defense and all that stuff. So Sharon is witness to being summoned.
Yeah.
And you're accused, and immediately you know.
Mine was worse. I was using my own social media account, my own personal account as Sharon. And I've been someone. I appeared before the FIFA disciplinary committee, my friend.
And you paid the fine?
Why?
Did you pay?
So Faith, you were saying?
So my issue here is, I feel like sometimes it'd be good to get to the bottom of all these things. Like now he's talking about a scenario where they probably had pulled up laws from FIFA and all that stuff. I wonder, do we subscribe to FIFA?
Of course we do.
We do.
Of course we do.
Yes.
Yes, we do. Yeah? It's like telling me, somebody was telling me that you have to first go by FUFA laws before the FIFA laws. I'm like, if between me and you we agree that when you see my kid going astray, kill that kid. Mm. We have agreed, I'm okay with it, you're okay with it. Mm. If you kill that kid, doesn't the don't the national laws come for you? But we have agreed between you and me. You know, so there has always a supreme law above the laws that we are going, especially in football.
So winding this up, do you think FUFA is politicking in any way?
I am not a politician. First and foremost, I am not. Honest, I am not a politician.
Is there anything?
I understand that. But as William, I am not a politician, and I always go by the facts. Mm. So that's why I don't really care how I look to other people.
We don't see the laws. So
what I was going to say is that if there is politics on their side, it's quite unfortunate, because on our side we are only fighting our corner. We are trying to go by what is right. We wanted to face Villa with a full strength team.
In the event that those two players were injured, would you have taken them to face Villa? Thank you very much.
If a player is injured and you can't field him, you forget about the player.
But he's not injured.
It is not injured.
Sharon.
By the way,
you're very well, and the show is going on. We can't forget about you because you're fine. Or you know,
international
break. So that's what it means. They weren't injured.
But for the players, I will not. Let me give you a scenario. When Villa was going to play Toro United in one of his early games in the first leg last season, what happened was that we had two players, Owori David, and I think there's some other midfielder, who was Kiria Ambrosius, who was someone for the national team. And the next day was supposed to travel to Toro to go and play. Do you know we traveled without Owori? Do you know that? We even played without Owori David. Can you imagine that?
Why?
I mean, because there was someone at the national team. They were in a residential camp.
Even in the middle of the season, Mwale Tatimu, Kabiri Timu, Mwale Tatimu, 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 campaign? Was it his decision, the club's decision, or something?
Bisaso, this thing was not abrupt. Even before the big league was halfway, there was this course, yeah? And we promised him that, no, wait, at the end of this season, you will go. We agreed between both, because even it's us guys who are sending him there anyway. So we agreed with him that at the end of this season, you will go. But he was supposed to go for a short time and come back. Okay. So when the course came up, and it was now long term, we had to find a long term solution.
Okay, yeah? I know this is not the end of it all. Other clubs might face this. What is your appeal to FUFA before we go?
My appeal to FUFA is this.
In the camera, tell them.
Okay, my appeal to FUFA is this. What Proline is talking about is not at all a new thing. It is not something weird. It's not something out of the blue. Even in Uganda before, we have observed International Week, FIFA International Week. There's nothing spectacular about this whole thing of Proline and Villa and so on and so forth. I'm just calling and beseeching FUFA that sane mind should prevail over this thing. It's not politics, it's not anything, we are just fighting our corner. We need to face all clubs, all matches with a full strength side. That's all we want.
Well said. Thanks for honoring our invite. Let's go for a short commercial break. We will be right back. Don't go away.
Sportswoman.